Welcome back to Lock and Reload. Today we're going to go ahead and do an overview and a review of the Howa M1500. A little bit before we get into the actual rifle, a little bit of history. Howa's been around between World War I and World War II. They've been around a couple days. They actually originally started making fabric looms. And then they moved on to making 22-inch guns for their Japanese warships. Howa is a Japanese company. Now, up until the late 60s, early 70s, if I'm wrong, by the way, leave a comment at the bottom, let me know, but I'm pretty sure I'm pretty accurate. Anyway, between the late 60s, early 70s, they started making rifles. Don't ask me the name of the rifles of the prior to the M1500, because I don't know. I didn't really get into that kind of depth with their history. So, to the overview of the Howa M1500. This is the M1500. It is in bolt action. We are going to do a chamber check. She's empty. Like I stated, this is bolt action. It does have internal 5-round magazine. Or for all you techie guys, 4+1. I like internal mag, it's so much easier, and they're a lot better than any box mag. The action and the bolt were designed after Weatherby, the Weatherby action. Like most people say, if it ain't broke, why fix it? That's why they went with the Weatherby action. This thing was topped off with a Nico and Sterling Night Eater scope. This one's 3x10 by 42mm. This one also has a Hogue overmold synthetic stock. I hate synthetic stocks, but this is the exception to the rule. This one is chambered in 308. Like my last videos, my reloading videos were me reloading 308, and that's for this guy. Very accurate. I'm very happy with this rifle. 575 rounds, and she hasn't failed yet. But like I said, this thing's like driving a Cadillac. Compared to shooting my Mosians, yeah, this thing's like driving a Cadillac. Don't get me wrong, 308 isn't the snottiest cartridge as far as recoil, but she's got snort, trust me. I shot in a lot of different rifles, and this one is probably the most comfortable. The barrel on here is 22 inches. It's a standard barrel, blued steel. There are many different variations of this rifle. I'm not going to get into the variations, so that's why at the bottom of the screen I am going to leave Legacy Sports International's website, and for whatever application, you know, you can find it. Like I stated, they have various rifles that you can buy in many different calibers. So you choose the application, so you choose the rifle. All in all, like I stated, 575 rounds. This thing has not failed me yet. This thing is really accurate. So my next video, I will take this out to the range. I will basically show you how it recoils and how little recoil this thing has. My buddy Nick actually has a 300 Winchester and a Howa M1500. M1500 is a 300 Winchester Magnum. So you'll get the idea between a short action and a long action. And if you don't know the difference between a short action and a long action, think of it this way. Long action is going to be the Magnum, the short Magnum is going to be the 308, hence the term Magnum. Just a longer case. Long action, long case. So hopefully in the next week or so, I will be able to get these things out to the range. And then hopefully after that one, we can go ahead and put in a disassembly. But like I stated, with the Nico Sterling scope and the rifle itself with the Hogue overmold, this thing is about about $550 for this rifle. For the money you spend on it, great rifle. Don't worry, this isn't like Daewoo, like I stated before. This isn't just cheap shit. This is good stuff. Japanese know how to make a rifle. But so that's basically my overview of the Howa M1500. This is Lock and Load. Later.